Hello friends, Namaskar. Retirement is a very important event in the life of a person, particularly if I would say a serviceman, that a person during the course of his whole lifetime keeps on thinking about that, okay, when he will retire, he will be having so much of funds or he will be financially independent. So what are the various points which a person at the time of retirement should consider for the financial planning at such retirement point of time? Through this video, I am going to throw upon light on certain important points which are important for any person who is just retired. And such points, if he will take care about in his mind, will certainly be helpful to him, in my opinion, from the point of view of saying a financial planning appropriately done at the time of retirement. My dear friends, here I am first putting up before you what are the challenges at the time of retirement which a person might be facing or which he needs to answer upon. 1. How to manage the funds for best returns. How to ensure security of the funds which he'll be getting at the time of retirement. How to ensure regular source of income apart from pension, which is a very big challenge. Tax planning through relatives, if it could be done, what it could be, we will discuss in this particular video. Whether the planning for healthcare is required, if yes, then what could be the probable mode. Ensuring nominations or writing a will, whether it has any use in terms of your financial planning or not, that is also a point which we will discuss, my dear friends, through this video. Now, as I said in beginning that I'll be discussing few points which are going to work as a food for thought. So you may think about these points while deciding that, okay, how you are going to manage your retirement funds. And these points, I'm hopeful, will be certainly useful to you. Like, I'm of the mind, if a person retires, he should think about that, okay, what are his priorities? Priorities means, what are the personal needs of the families? Say, for example, if a person has spent whole of his life in a rented premise, then at the time of retirement, he might be thinking of that, okay, now let's own a particular house which is of your own, which is under your ownership. That could be one priority. Sometimes the children are young, so you may be needing the funds for their education purposes, for their marriage purposes. Sometimes you don't have a regular source of income in form of pension, then you need a regular source of income in form of interest. So setting up the priorities at the time of retirement is very much important to see that you are going to use your funds in the right direction. Thereafter, I am of the mind that a person at the time of retirement should think about allocating the funds from non-risky portfolio to risky portfolio. That is, in an ascending order, when you pick up your investment modes, you should first think about non-risky investment rather than thinking about the risky investment, because the non-risky investments will be helpful to you in terms of protecting your hard-earned money, protecting your capital which you have earned during the whole lifetime of your service. Further, I also suggest that one should leave the temptation of higher returns or the interest rate. It has been seen in various examples, my dear friend. People have earned their hard-earned money at the time of retirement. They approached to the bank who said, okay, we'll offer you 5%, 6%, 7% interest rate. And some Ponzi scheme wherein they got indulged for an interest rate of 15%, 22%, 2 years double, 3 year double scheme kind of thing. And ultimately they have lost their principal here. So one has to leave the temptation of higher return. It is unfortunate that we don't have very high interest paying return schemes in India as on date for the retired person. But it does not mean that for the sake of good return, I have to put my whole money which I have earned and which I am getting at the time of retirement on the stick. Secondly, in addition to it, I would advise that please avoid making investment in real estate unless it is required for your self-residence or you want to develop a kind of rental proposition for you, because the main proposition, I don't say that real estate is not a good investment option, but if I correlate the real estate investment with the objective which I have set in through this particular video, you might not be able to sell the property in terms of you needing the funds at an instant level. So that is one criteria which prompted me to advise in this manner. I would also advise that you should avoid lending to the private parties or unsecured loans. Many a time it happens that somebody knows that you might have earned or you might have got some funds of 50 lakh, 30 lakh, 100 lakh, and he says that, okay, I'll pay you 12%, 15%, 18% interest. I have a strong company, I have a strong firm. Why don't you lend it to me? I'll keep on giving it to you. And see, I have paid to so much so in the preceding years also to you. I would also say that even if a person has paid to you in past, it does not mean that in future he will continue to be able to pay you such a good amount of interest. Still, I would not say a no to it, but you should think about that you should avoid lending to the private parties or unsecured loan because it is your hard-earned money. You should avail the help of a consultant. This is my opinion. But don't forget to ask queries. A consultant may be a chartered accountant, a consultant may be an investment advisor, maybe a tax consultant, would certainly be there to help out to you in terms of you deciding, okay, where you should invest your retirement fund. But before you are investing as per their advice, you should ask fullest queries which are possible. Further, I also keep on advising to those wherein I come into interaction that, sir, please don't lock up funds for a very long period. Very long period means, say, for example, somebody is wishing to investment for 5 year, 8 year, 10 year. We should see that, okay, according to our priorities, at what duration I'll be in need of fund. So say you are putting up funds into FDs. Then you should plan some FDs for 2 years, some FD for 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. So it will keep on maturing. And at that time, at the time of maturity, such person who has retired would be able to decide, okay, where he actually want to put up those funds at the time of maturity. If he doesn't want, then he can renew that particular FD again. So picking up the funds and then using them for a very long period for investment is not advisable in my opinion, where you are doing the retirement related fund management, the retirement related financial planning of yours. Now, a very important question is there before you, friends, that is how to ensure security of funds, which is a very big critical issue for any person who is ensuring his retirement planning in terms of retirement funds related planning. Now, here I have some suggestions for you. One, keeping investment in fixed deposit versus saving bank deposit. Why I have highlighted this here, sir? I've seen many a person are also doing this kind of thing that they are putting or they are keeping good amount of funds in their saving bank account rather than converting them into FDs. Mind you, my dear friends, FD does not mean a longer term FD. An FD may be as short as a 15 days FD. If you keep your funds into saving bank account, then they will fetch you a lower interest rate as compared to you keeping them in fixed deposit. So keeping big amount of funds in saving bank, unless you need them in short term, would not be a good advice. Then you should think about keeping them into a FD. Ensuring division of amount in multiple fixed deposit. This is another suggestion. Say for example, a person retired, he is of the mind that, okay, I will put up 30 lakh rupees into FD. A person like me would suggest him, sir, if you want to do a FD of rupees 30 lakh, please don't do a 30 lakh rupees FD one go. Let's say you keep 5 lakh rupees FD every year renewing. Then you are left up with 25 lakh rupees. Let's say another 5 year is 2 year maturity thing. And 10-10, you can do 3 year and 5 year FD. Now he can ask me, okay, what is the sense of doing this, Mr. Bhatia? I may lose some interest. See, when you sometime you need the funds in urgency and you want to break up your full FD of rupees 30 lakh, you will be losing interest on such particular FD because it is a bulk amount FD, single FD. If you book the FD into bits and pieces, then you will be breaking only those FDs which are required to suffice that fund requirement which has arose at that particular time. So probably this kind of advice would be helpful to you at such a point of time. taking a stock of investment from time to time is a very crucial activity, my dear friend, because ensuring security of fund is not required only at the time of making a particular investment. But if you are reviewing your funds from time to time, that will also be helpful to you in ensuring that your funds, which you have got through your hard-earned money at the time of retirement, are kept safe. Some people ask me, Mr. Bhatia, tell me that should I invest into private sector bank because they may be paying a higher interest rate as compared to PSU bank. My dear friends, I can say that when it is concerned with the banks, may it be private sector or PSUs, people have a preference of investing in PSUs because they are assumed to be more safer. Yet, FD amount remains unsecured beyond certain amount with all the banks. But I would not say that you keep the full money into PSU or full money into private sector. You can divide it and accordingly you can take an exposure. One thing which some people would not like to hear from me, this kind of thing, but I had an experience that placing too much of funds into cooperative bank, which are smaller banks, sometimes is risky. So one should take that particular point in mind and one should prefer that, okay, if possible, then the large chunk should be kept in the PSU banks or in the private bank rather than keeping it straight away into cooperative banks. If they don't have the good network, the good net worth basis, that one should consider. Banks versus NBFC is a very important and critical point, my dear friends, because banks are considered to be more safer as compared to non-banking financial companies. I would not say that you should not invest in NBFCs, but in past, people had experience of investing in NBFCs and which was more risk prone as compared to investing in kind of FDs with the bank. So one should think about this particular perspective. Fixed deposits versus mutual fund, that is also one point which may come in the mind of a person who is an investor at the time of retirement. Sir, fixed deposits are more safe even if you are comparing them with the liquid funds. But people may think about, or a person may think about, investing some chunks of the amount into mutual fund even. Availing fixed income products of life insurance companies is also an option which people ask us. Usually, sir, I can say that investing in the life insurance companies with fixed income product is not that risky as the risk is involved in the share market. But you should know that when you are investing into a life insurance company, are they offering you fixed income or they are offering you a ULIP product? Mind you, my dear friend, a unit linked insurance plan offered to you at the time of retirement may be a risky product because it is linked to the share market. But a fixed income product offered by a life insurance company may not have that much of risk as compared to a ULIP product. This is one point which you should take care of. Availing a loan versus repayment of existing loan. Sometimes there are two points which I want to cover here off, my dear friend. People may ask me that, Mr. Bhatia, tell me that if I've got say 70 lakh rupees at time of retirement, I have an outstanding loan of rupees 20 lakh. Should I continue with that or should I first pay off it? My first suggestion to such person is, sir, why don't you pay it off? Because you might be paying 8%, 9% interest on the loan, whereas on an FD, you may be getting 5%, 6% interest. So that is one good option. Another thing, you will be released in terms of your tension of paying EMIs if you are not having the regular source of income or you may have other financial obligation. Some people might think about that, okay, why I should not avail a further loan at the time of retirement because I have good pension income. If you have a pension income, I don't deny that you should not avail a loan. But generally, sir, at the time of retirement, we should think of not availing the loans further. This is where if I am asked to plan for my retirement, I would think in that manner, at least on the date of retirement and thereafter, I don't have any loan on my head to think about its repayment. So these are few suggestions, my dear friend, which you may take care about. Now, a very important question is how to ensure regular source of income, which is a very big challenge. Because if you have pension income, then that is one of the regular source of income. Sometimes pension might not be sufficient, so the funds which you are receiving at the time of retirement, from them, you may be in need of generating certain extra income, say in form of interest, etc. So how to ensure regular source of income apart from pension? Here my suggestion to you is that Let's say we put up some amount into a MIS scheme, that is monthly income scheme, or a quarterly income plan, which may get you some interest on a monthly basis also, rather than picking up straight away accumulative FDs wherein the whole amount of FD along with interest is paid to you at the maturity of the particular FD. So you may think about it. Secondly, there are two very important schemes, my dear friend, which are quite safe and which are paying reasonable returns, say around 7.4%, which are Senior Citizen Saving Scheme and which is Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandan Yojana. So you as a senior citizen may think about these particular plans also to be availed for parking certain say amount of 15 lakh rupees is allowed in both the scheme, which may get you a reasonable return and safe return from the point of view of retirement financial planning. Systematic withdrawal plan is a mutual fund related products, my dear friend. I am not saying that you should think about it only, but I am saying that, okay, if you are ready to bear some risk of putting the money into mutual fund, then systematic withdrawal plan, what happens, say you put up your 20 lakh rupees out of 80 lakh rupees retirement proceeds into a mutual fund, and from 20 lakh, say you pick up 10,000 rupees monthly withdrawal. So they are not paying you any interest. This is your withdrawal, 10,000 per month. Now, when you withdraw 10,000 on 1 month, the remaining 19,90,000 is still invested into share market. That will fetch you further return. So over a longer period of time, I have seen that mutual fund is giving you a good return. But before investing into a systematic withdrawal plan, you should understand the scheme properly. You should see the past performance. You should have a perception of the share market, and some knowledge of the mutual fund product and share market would also be required. I would rather advise at such particular case, you should avail help of a consultant. Some people may also think about investing in certain shares. There are good shares which are giving you dividend on an annual basis. So you may think about certain shares. If you are interested in investing in share, on those shares which are giving good dividend payout every year, that could be one area where you may invest. Where you are interested in some property which may fetch you some rent, my dear friend, you may think about in such rental property also. But wherever you are generating the income from rented property as a senior citizen, my suggestion to you is that please ensure that the rent agreement is a registered rent agreement or a lease agreement, which is duly registered with the stamp duty authorities. This will help you that you don't have a bodhration kind of thing, you don't have a kind of tension on your mind that if tomorrow the property is not vacated, what will happen? Because there is a registered lease, there is a registered agreement that will help you in getting the possession also as and when required. So these are few ideas regarding a regular source of income from my side for you. Tax planning through relatives is a very important point which some people ask me when they have some funds at the time of retirement. Okay, sir, Mr. Bhatia, tell me, if I want to put some money in form of FD in my wife's account and we book certain interest there. See, out of love and affection and there being a spouse with you who has been there along with you during the whole lifetime and even post-retirement, she or he is there going to be with you. There is no question at all in terms of putting some funds in their account and booking FD there. But I would suggest you that such kind of action of yours would attract the provisions of Section 64 of Income Tax Act, which says that the income therefrom earned by such particular person would be clubbed back in your hands. So to clubbing point of view, you should think about that, say out of 80 lakh rupees which a person receives, say he books 30 lakh rupees as FD in the name of his spouse, the income of interest prima facie is coming back to that person, that is the retired person, from the point of view of taxation. However, if you talk about the transfer of funds to the son or daughter or grandchildren who may be major or even minor, in that case, I am of the mind that you may book certain FDs in the name of son or daughter. You may book FDs in the name of grandchildren even. But when you are booking FDs in the name of your children or in the name of your grandchildren, you should see that whether you are going to take back that money or you are giving it as a gift. Because usually when you give the money in the name of children, you are not expecting it to be returned back. if you are seeing it from a point of view of taxation aspects, say for example, a person has 19 years old girl as child and he just retired, and that girl child is still studying, who may be studying up to age of 23, 24 years. So he may plan that, okay, Mr. Bhatia, for another 3-4 years, let me generate the interest in her hands because I am already into a good tax slab. Then can I keep the funds in her name and then I can take it back? I would say, sir, no issue. If you have the full faith in that particular term, then you can do this kind of planning also. One very important aspect, my dear friends, is planning for healthcare. If you are having a coverage in terms of medical coverage through your ex-employer, then there is no issue. Yet in such particular case also, you should think about, say for example, your ex-employer offers you some 10 lakh rupees coverage, or an ex-employer offers you at certain prescribed rate, say for a heart surgery, they provide for 50,000 rupees provision. Whereas if a heart surgery may be needed, then you may be in the requirement of fund of rupees 2 lakh. Either you will plan through your FDs, through your funds which you are keeping idle, or I may suggest that why don't you obtain a good health cover through an insurance policy. Even after having a coverage through state government, central government coverage, if you are obtaining a health cover from an insurance company, that will help you to ensure that you can ensure a treatment at a good hospital. You can ensure that your treatment at such particular hospital with a higher cost, say you book a premium room, you book a luxury room, that is also duly reimbursed. These kind of things could certainly be of importance in terms of your financial planning, because if you don't have a health cover and tomorrow you need funds, then your hard-earned money would go for that particular spending. If rather you have a health cover, say at a cost of 20,000, 30,000, 40,000 rupees a year, and you are getting a coverage of 10 lakh, 15 lakh, 20 lakh according to your understanding and requirement, then this is a good planning from the point of view of taking care of your health care. One more question, my dear friends, is ensuring nominations or will. Yet it is not forming part of financial planning directly, but as a suggestion, I added these particular points here, that whether the nominations and wills are a must, a clear answer to them is a no. Secondly, nomination versus will, which to prefer? If somebody is of the mind that, okay, I don't want any nomination and will, it can't be forced upon him. But it is better to have nominations and will. Now, what is the difference between these two? Let me also elaborate that thing to you. My dear friends, say nomination facilities available in certain cases like FDs, mutual fund, bank account balances, NBFC deposits, etc., share market, demat accounts. Through nomination, what happens if X dies and his successor is Y, then to Y, by nomination, all the assets which have been nominated in the name of Y will straight away go to Y. Please understand, the nominee is not a successor in terms of being a legal owner, being an owner of that particular property. If there are certain other persons who are inheriting the property, then nominee is the person who is supposed to distribute the asset amongst all those legal heirs. One. So nominee is a representative of the person. Secondly, if a person is writing a will, through that he can do a clear-cut distinguishment in terms of to whom he wants to give what. So nomination and will both are suggestive. You may think about whether you want to do nomination or you want to do will. But if you do so, that makes the life of the successors also easy in the future. And I say that this is nothing wrong if you consider these points in form of your financial planning, because that helps that, okay, when we are not there in this world, then we are not creating trouble for our successors. We have given them a smooth asset takeover program. So I think from that perspective, one should take care about these points even. I know, my dear friends, it's quite a long video, must have taken a lot of your time, but retirement related financial planning, particularly at the time of retirement, is quite an untouched issue where a lot of people remain confused and sometimes they lose their hard-earned money because of not availing the right advice. So through this video, in terms of my financial literacy program, in terms of my thinking that, okay, the financial literacy in India should be improved, I try to contribute my level best. I think, my dear friend, this video would have served your purpose. If you have any query in your mind, you can ask me. I'll be there to trying there to give a solution to you. Thank you very much for being with me, listening to me. Wish you all the best. Wish you a very happy Deepavali. Jai Hind.